Hello, this is Dr. Mahesh Kalyanshetti, Associate Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we'll discuss about IS soil classification system. The learning outcome is, at the end of this session, students will be able to classify the soil in accordance with IS 1498-1970. Now let us see what are the purposes of soil classification. The soil classification system are established to help people predict soil behavior and to provide a common language for soil scientists. Another purpose is to arrange the various types of soil into groups according to their engineering or various other characteristics. And the soil possessing similar characteristics can be placed in the same group. So the sole purpose of all this soil classification is to group the soil into different categories based on their properties. There exist many soil classification systems. This is a list. The first one is the particle size classification, wherein the classification is made based on the particle size. Second one is the textural classification. So based on the texture of the soil, the classification is made. Third one is the Highway Research Board, HRB classification. It's a British system. Then fourth one is the Unified Soil Classification System. And fifth one is Indian Standard Classification System. So we'll focus on the Indian Standard Classification System. Prior to that, we'll also discuss the soil classification system based on the particle size. So particle size classification, here the classification is made based on the particle size of the soil particles. So the soils are arranged according to their grain size. The terms such as gravel, sand, silt and clay are used to indicate the grain sizes, and these terms are used only as designation of particle sizes. They do not signify naturally occurring soil types, and naturally occurring soils are mixture of particles of different sizes. So this is what is the IS classification as per IS 1498-1970. So based on the soil particle size, the classification is made. Now you can see here the particles finer than 0.002 mm are called as clay, and then from 0.002 mm to 0.075 it is called as a silt, and from 0.075 mm up to 4.75, this particular soil is basically a sand. And in the sand again, division is made based on the size. So it's a fine grained soil up to 0.425, medium grained soil up to 2 mm, and then the coarse grained soil. Then the particles having a size more than 4.75 is called as a gravel. Up to 80, it is a gravel. And here again in the gravel, we have two category. One is called fine gravel, another is coarse gravel. So based on this particle size, beyond 80 mm up to 300 mm, the particles are called as cobble, and beyond 300 mm, it is called boulder. So let us move to the IS soil classification system as per 1498-1970. So as per this IS code, the soil is classified into two categories basically. One is called coarse grain, another is called fine grain. However, if you have a high organic content, so that it can be separately classified as highly organic soil. So for as far as the inorganic soil, we have two categories: coarse grain soil and fine grain soil. So coarse grain soils are the soil where we have 50% or less material is passing 75 micron, and fine grain soil is more than 50% passing 75 micron sieve. Now let us concentrate on the coarse grain soil. So in the coarse grain soil, again we have the two types. One is called gravel and another is sand. Now this distinguish we can make based on the sieve analysis, and we can see that the percentage of material retained on 4.75. so based on this percentage, we can classify whether it is gravel or sand. And if it is a percentage of coarse fraction retained on 4.75 mm sieve is greater than 50%, it is called gravel. And if it is less than 50%, usually it is called as sand. Now further we can have a classification of the gravel and sand. So in the next slides we will see how the gravel is further classified. So here gravel is again further classified, so based on again the fine materials present in the soil. So if you have less than 5% passing 75 micron sieve, then we have the two options. Less than 5% passing 75 micron sieve, it means we have a very small amount of fines present. This is regarding the fines, means percentage passing 75 micron. So we have two possibilities, well graded or poorly graded. So this can be identified based on the criteria given, and we have some specific criteria for well graded and poorly graded soil that we will see in the other presentation. So if it is well graded, then it has been given a symbol as ZW. G stands for gravel and W stands for well graded. And if it is poorly graded, its a symbol is GP, that is gravel, and P is poorly graded. But if the fines are between 5% to 12%, you can see here, passing 75 microns means what? These are called as a fines. If the fines present are in between 5% to 12%, it means that substantial quantity of fine material is present, therefore we cannot neglect those fine materials, and for that we have to see a line chart which has been given by IS code. So this chart is also called as a line chart or plasticity chart. So here based on this particular graph, now if a liquid limit and plastic limit, based on our liquid limit and plastic limit, if our point comes out above a line, then it is called as a clay. Below a line, it is a silt. And if the point is in the hatched zone, it is a combination of silt and clay. To see whether it is above a line or below a line. So if it is above a line, it is a GC, means gravel consisting clay particles. If it is in the hatched zone, then you can see silt and clay both are present. It is GM, GC. And if it is below a line, it is a silt. Therefore, it is GM. So in the same thing is for sand. Now for the sand also we can see the classification is of same nature. So here also we classify the sand further based on the finer material, whether it is less than 5%, 5 to 12% or more than 12%. And the same system we follow here as it has been followed for the gravel. Only thing you can see here, instead of G, we find SS everywhere. This is what is a change. Now I will request you to take a pause and solve this problem. A soil sample has 72% of mass retained on 75 micron sieve. Out of this, 55% of mass is retained on 4.75 mm sieve. Classify the soil. So take a pause and classify the soil. Welcome back. Hope you have come with the solution. So this is what is the problem, and we know that now, just now we discussed in the earlier slides that based on the 75 micron sieve, so it is more than 72%, means 50% is retained, therefore it is basically a gravel, or it is a coarse grain soil basically. Then again on 4.75 also more than 50% is retained, therefore it is a gravel. So based on this flow chart we can very easily identify that the given type of soil is gravel. Let us come to the classification of the fine grain soil. Now for the fine grain soil, you can see here, now coarse grain soil we just now finished. Now come to the fine grain soil, it is more than 50% passing 75 micron sieve. It means that all the particles are of very fine size, and in such cases the classification is totally based on a line chart or plasticity chart. So this is called as a plasticity chart. In the plasticity chart we see that on x-axis there is a liquid limit plotted, on y-axis there is a plasticity index. And we have certain lines plotted here. So this inclined line is called as A line, which has got this equation which is given here. And apart from this line, we have two vertical lines. One is at liquid limit 35, another is at liquid limit 50. And we have the hatched zone here for plasticity index 4 and 7. So in between this, we have the hatched portion. So this particular lines divide this area into number of segments, and above the inclined line, above the A line, all the soil is a clay. You can see here the CCC everywhere, and below A line it's a silt. And whenever we come up across with the hatched zone, it's a combination of clay and silt. At the same time, below 35, liquid limit 35, it is a low compressible soil. Liquid limit 35 to 50, it is a medium compressible, and beyond 50%, it is a high compressible soil. So based on this, some symbols are given. So we can see here, in this zone, it is CL. C means clay, low compressible. This is C, intermediate compressible, because it is in between these two lines. And this is C, that means clay with high compressibility. In the same way, below A line, we find the silt everywhere. So it is MH or organic soil. This is MI or organic soil. And this is ML or organic soil. So in this way, we can have different segments here. Now what we have to do is, based on our properties, based on our data, we have to see where our point comes. So if it comes in this particular segment, then our soil is a MH type of soil. If my point comes in this particular zone, then it is called a CH type of soil. That means clay with high compressibility. So this we'll discuss with the help of small problem. So let us take one example. So classify the soil with following data. So passing 75 micron is 68%, liquid limit is 45%, plastic limit is 20%. So therefore, now since it is more than 50% passing 75 micron, therefore it is a fine grained soil, therefore we have to refer the A-line chart. And now find the liquid limit, it is my point comes here. So as it has been shown by B here. So this point is now in the zone of CI, you can see. Therefore, my soil is clay with intermediate compressibility. So these are the references used for the presentation. Thank you.